Hello everyone. Today I'm making lotus root soup with pork leg. And you see a little carrot there for color. And a little green. And what green is that? I will review later. If you are interested to see how I make it, please come to the kitchen with me. Welcome to Saigon Cook Travel. I am Saigon Cook. So I bought a pork leg here. So in the store they already slice up because it's very hard if you don't have a cleaver to do so at home. And if you watch my videos often, you will see how I clean my meat at home. First, rub it with salt and lemon slice or lime slice. And after that, I bring a pot of water to a boil. Add salt and vinegar, and I drop in my meat, and I blanch it for 3 minutes and remove from there, and I submerge it into water. Now I bring another pot of water with onion, garlic, shallots, and horn black peppercorns. And I added the blanched pieces of meat in the pot and cook. I bring it to a boil, and as you can see, now the scum rises on the surface, and you need to remove the scums if you want your broth is clear. And in our cooking, people appreciate a clear broth. It's just like a consommé, clear and flavorful. That's what we try to achieve when we cook this soup. For the pork legs, this is a tough pot of meat. That's why you need to cook long. And at this point, you have your preference. Do you like your preference? Yes. Because when you are a cook, you like how your food to be. So at that point, you can decide the tenderness of your meat. I like my meat tender, but the tendon is still crunchy. So I cook my pork meat for 45 minutes. And like I said, it's up to you. If you want tender, more tender, you cook longer. If you like more, you like crunchier, you cook less. Now we got to the vegetable parts. That is the stars of the soup today. Lotus roots. If you live close to Asian market, you can get your hands on these ingredients. Lotus is a very wonderful plant. Everything of it is used. The roots we cook in soup, or sometimes people do lotus chips. And the stem, you can do the salad. The flower, you enjoy the flower. The seeds, when the flower are mature, you can cook in soup or eat rule. And the lotus roots has like 11, 15 quality benefits to our body. It help immune system, lower cholesterol, hypertension, give us energy, help with iron parts for the body, help with digestion, and so on. You Google it and you will find out, okay? Now, I only dream of on the bruised paw, the dark paw from my lotus root, and I cut it up into slices. And now I make my carrot flowers by scoring the three slot around the perimeter of my carrots, and that's it. And I slide them down into slices, and I have carrot flowers. And now I onto my green onion I grow in my garden. I come back to the lotus roots because the roots is in the mud on the thigh, it will get dark. If you like it white, you can soak them into the vinegar water. And here is my green secret that I told you earlier. That is the cilantro and Thai basil. I will chop them together with the green onion and we'll sprinkle into the soup at the last minute. It will bring aroma, very fantastic aroma, and you will like it. Now I tested my pork pieces, and they are tender enough now. So I add my lotus in. Remember, lotus took long time to cook too. So like 20 minutes into cooking the pork, you can add your lotus root. And also, is again, is up to you. If you like your the lotus tender, you add at 20 minutes. If you not, you like them still crunchy, you add it when the pork is 30 minutes or tender. And when you add the carrot, it's about 10 minutes before the cooking done, because the carrot is very easy to cook tenderly. And the way you test your piece, you use your chopstick or a fork to break the lotus pieces to see it's tender for you, and you can taste it. Because people can eat this raw, so it doesn't harm you anything if you try to eat a raw piece. But don't eat too much, because like I said, the lotus root is in the mud. You don't know what mud they are in, so better cook it properly carefully so that we have a safe, good product. And after everything tender, I finish cooking, and I will present my food now. I use this white bowl to be beautiful, and I have some beautiful statues to display together. So I go with the white bowl today. So I try to show off my lotus root and the pork leg at the same time. So take me for a while. In the meantime, I like to take opportunity to say thank you for stopping by watching my video. It means a lot to me. If you are new to my channel, please like, share my video, and subscribe to my channel. This is your reward to me. I have passion for food. I like cooking, baking, home improvement, gardening, and everything in between. And everything I know, I like to share it with you. Back in the day, anytime I had time, I register classes, pay money, go learn cooking, and I make all the effort. So now, whatever I know, I like to share it with you. Just come to watch my channel. Subscribe to me, okay? Now, I'm done with the presentation. I think I'm happy with it. Now, I add the tip of my culantro. All it needs now is a little peppercorn. I grind up fresh so that it smells wonderful now. Alright, I think it's time for us to eat. Oh, this is all the statue I bring across with me from Vietnam. They are from stones. Alright, so I like you to taste it with me. You can see I use my chops that I can break my piece of lotus away. That means very tender. I like my lotus tender. And I achieved this. And now, let's taste some of the broth. That is the key of the soup. The broth is sweet, savory, warm, hot, and feel good after some shipping. And now the meat part. This part is a tendon piece. So it's the meat a little here, but the meat is tender and the skin is tender. The tendon is crunchy. That's what I want. So I keep enjoying the soup, and I hope you enjoy it as well. Please like, share, and subscribe to my channel, and come back, see me with the other videos. I will see you soon. Thank you. Bye bye and have a great day.